NGA. We're gonna learn it from NGA. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from Angie.
That's me. Welcome to Engineering Expo. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go.
Hi, my name is Minisa. I'm a certification engineer at Aeronautics, and I'm also part of the SWE Engineering Expo Committee. This is Shaina.
Hi, I'm Shaina, and I'm an engineer at Textron Aviation Defense working as a product manager. I'm also part of the SWE Engineering Expo Committee.
Today, we're here to do marker chromatography, and here is a list of the equipment you will need.
So what is chromatography?
Well, chromatography is a process that scientists can use to separate a liquid into its individual components. For instance, on this experiment, we are going to be using marker ink as our liquid.
So how are colors made?
Well, colors are made from the individual components. They could be man-made synthetic or they can be natural, and they're mixed together to make a color. We know at this age about primary colors. So what is orange?
Orange is made up of red and yellow.
Okay, where our eyes see orange, but in reality, it's still red and yellow components mixed together.
What about a black marker?
I don't know, Shaina. The experiment we could do is to determine what colors are used to make black. Shall we?
Let's do it. So first, you're gonna add a few inches of water to the bottom of your glass or glasses if you're doing multiple experiments.
Thank you.
The next thing you'll want to do is cut a strip out of a coffee filter about the width of your glass. If you don't have coffee filters, you can use paper towel.
So what I'm going to do is I have two glasses, so I have two water filters, and I'm going to cut a strip out of the middle of my filters.
So next, you'll want to line your filter up next to your glass and mark the spot where you want to make a marker line. You want it to be about an inch or so above the water. So I'm going to make mine right here.
I'm going to do mine right here. Now, the markers can bleed, so we have extra paper here to protect the surface that we're working on. So I'm going to separate my two filters out, and I'm actually using a brown and a green marker.
And I'm going to use purple and black. And you want to make your marker line about a finger width thick. Then you're going to place the filter into the glass, and you want to make sure that the bottom is in the water, but that your marker line is above the water level. And you're going to tape that to the back of the glass to hold it in place.
So now that we have these in the water, what we're waiting on, the water is going to be absorbed into the coffee filter. As it reaches the marker, it's going to start to separate that liquid out, and hopefully it will separate into some different colors that we can look at.
So now we wait. See you soon. Oh, wow, look at these colors.
Yes, our experiment today for the marker chromatography went really well. We were able to use the water it absorbed into our coffee filter, and it basically dissipated the marker ink so we could see the individual colors that make up that primary color.
Now, this separation took about 30 minutes using the coffee filter. If you want that to go faster, you could try paper towel instead. But on our green marker here, you can clearly see that it separated into yellow and blue, which is what we would expect from our primary colors.
The brown marker we can see has a few other colors. It has red down below. It has yellow right underneath the brown. On top of it, you could see black, and in the corner, you can start to see the blue start to peek through.
Now the black separation is interesting because it looks that it's primarily red and blue that you see. Now we know that those aren't all the colors that go into black, but the darker, more dominant colors are what we're able to see separated out.
Last we have is the purple. We can see that the water did dissipate the purple nicely. Unfortunately, we don't really see much separation of color. And that's okay. Not all experiments are going to be perfect. So, Shaina, what color was your favorite?
I liked the green. What about you?
I liked the brown because it has the most colors that we can see.
So what colors do you think a blue marker would separate into? Write down your guess in your engineering notebook.
Thank you for joining us for our marker chromatography lesson today. I hope you had a good time.
Try using a different marker at home. Take a picture or a short video of your experiment and post it to our Facebook event page for a chance to win a prize.
Until then,
see you next time.
You start. Shaina, have you ever wondered how colors are made?
Yes, how are they made, Minisa?
Thank you for joining us for this marker chromatology. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from Angie.
That's me. Thanks for joining us today. See you next time.